Hi all, Allison Hiltz here. I know I've been a little bit MIA lately, but I wanted to hop on and share where I've been and what my current experiences are. I am battling a kidney stone that is causing a blockage and will be going in for emergency surgery tomorrow. And after going through a round of pity party, why me, why midterms, why is this interfering with GOTV? This isn't convenient for me. I have things to do. I have a job. I can't just take time off. A wise friend informed me that maybe I should be focusing on the positive. And the positive side is that I have employer-based health coverage, which means that when I go in for surgery tomorrow, I will be covered by FMLA. I cannot lose my job. And I will be paying a copay that is affordable, meaning that I don't have to choose between paying my mortgage and getting treated for this, and without which I could have long-term consequences and problems from. So I decided to give the hospital where I'm having the procedure a call and ask them how much this procedure would cost me if I did not have health insurance. And the answer was $13,531.38. Bottom line, baseline. That does not include anesthesia or the stent they have to put in or removing it or recovery time. It does not include my previous visits to urgent care, pre-op, regular visits, blood work, all the other tests they've done, CT scan. All of that is not included in that baseline $13,500. And I don't know about you, but I don't think that most people have $13,500 to pay out in order to get treated for something that is the size of a grain of rice. And I am so grateful that I have this insurance, and that's why I'm urging you to vote for Jason Crow for Congress, because Jason understands that the average American cannot afford to be sidelined by something like this, and that we cannot be in a position where we're choosing between paying our mortgage or feeding our kids or keeping our jobs and having a treatment or a procedure that is absolutely necessary, both from a pain perspective, but also from a long-term kidney damage perspective. And so I'm asking you to please vote for Jason Crow. If you haven't voted yet, there are plenty of ways to do so. It's too late to mail in your ballot, but you can drop it off at any of the ballot locations. If you don't have transportation, please reach out to the Jason Crow campaign. They can either help get you hooked up with someone who can get you there, or they can pick up your ballot for you. But this is too important of an election. Midterms are too important to sit idly by. And no matter what is happening, if you are being sidelined by a grain of rice, or if you are working two jobs to help take care of your family, please take the time to vote. Go out, vote for Jason Crow. Understand that these are real people's lives that are at risk here, and that not everyone is as fortunate as I am in having health coverage and a job that I will have when I'm done, and someone to drive me the more than an hour it's going to take to get to the facility that was able to squeeze me in for this emergency procedure. So I cannot repeat it again, but I can't say it enough. Please make sure that you vote for Jason Crow for Congress. And thank you to all of the volunteers and to everyone who's out knocking doors and making calls and texting and doing everything they can to make sure that we are electing someone to Congress who's going to help everyday Americans. So thank you, and I will see you all in a week.